Okay, moving on. Let's talk about everybody's favorite topic on this podcast. Epic Games and their many lawsuits.
This is a wild one because, like, first it was, you know, first Apple said this and then they reversed it. And I still think there's a lot of, like, little intricacies that, like, might not be conveyed or whatnot. But a lot happens. A lot went on. Well,
so we've talked about this previously, but the EU ruled that Apple needs to allow alternative app stores, sideloading apps,
yes,
and all USB-C,
yeah,
all of this stuff. A lot of it is only happening in the EU, though.
Correct.
And that is the alternative app stores. Mm-hmm. This is awesome for so many reasons. And I'm doing a video now on preserving games and emulation and modding and stuff, and how companies like Nintendo are trying really hard to fight against it. This EU ruling is so good for even stuff like games preservation.
Yeah.
But it's the fucking EU. We need this shit to happen here.
Yeah.
But anyway.
Okay.
This is the blowback from this ruling.
Yeah. First off, Apple kills Epic's iOS Game Store plans over App Store criticism. Epic plans to release its own third-party App Store on the iOS in the EU. It could be in trouble after Apple terminated the developer account it plans to use. In a blog post published today, the company shared a letter sent by Apple's lawyers, which called Epic verifiably untrustworthy and said Apple does not believe that Epic will comply with its contractual commitments under its developer agreement. Please be advised that Apple has, effective immediately, terminated the developer program membership of Epic Games Sweden AB, the letter, which is dated March 2nd, states. It cites Apple's contractual right to terminate its developer program license agreement with the company at Apple's sole discretion. While Apple's termination of the developer account impacts Epic's plans to launch its own app store on iOS, Epic CEO Tim Sweeney suggested it in a briefing.
Friend of the show,
because he liked a tweet of mine one time. He stated in a briefing that Epic could still bring back Fortnite to iOS via another company's third-party app store in the European Union. The exchange came in the wake of Apple announcing its plans to allow third-party app stores on iOS in the EU as a result of the Block's new Digital Markets Act regulation, which goes into effect this week. Epic quickly announced plans to launch a game store on iOS as a result of the changes and relaunch Fortnite on the platform following its removal in 2020. It announced it had secured the developer account for Epic Games Sweden on February 16th, reversing a ban Apple implemented alongside Fortnite's removal. Apple alluded to its earlier ongoing ban on Epic's accounts in a statement to The Verge. Epic's egregious breach of its contractual obligations to Apple led courts to determine that Apple has the right to terminate any or all of Epic Games' wholly owned subsidiaries, affiliates, and/or entities under Epic Games' control at any time and at Apple's sole discretion. In light of Epic's past and ongoing behavior, Apple chose to exercise that right, said spokesperson Fred Sands. In an email dated February 28th, shared by Epic Games, Apple's Phil Schiller contacted Sweeney to ask for written assurance that Epic Games will honor its commitments. Schiller cited concerns with Sweeney's public statements about Apple's DMA compliance, and the fact that Epic breached its agreement with Apple in 2020 by adding third-party payment support to Fortnite on iOS, resulting in its removal. In plain, unqualified terms, please tell us why we should trust Epic this time, Schiller's email concludes. Sweeney responded the same day, Epic and its subsidiaries are acting in good faith and will comply with all terms of current and future agreements with Apple and will be glad to provide Apple with any specific further assurances on the topic that you'd like.
Pause. So I need a little bit more of a refresher. The EU had some recent developments with Apple, what we talked about before.
Yeah.
But Epic Games sued Apple over stuff many years ago that
Correct.
We've also talked about on this show.
Correct.
They lost that parts of that lawsuit.
Yes.
Most of it, I think.
Most of it.
Did they win more of it in the EU?
Mm-mm.
No, this wasn't one of those cases?
Mm-mm.
Okay. So kind of this has nothing. The EU The EU situation kind of has nothing to do with Epic, but I would think that Epic sparked it.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so now this is Apple being extremely petty.
This is
and using their own like terms of service to be like, "Hey, we don't trust that you're going to abide by our terms." Yeah,
this is Apple saying like, "We don't. She can't sit with us. We don't like her because one thing she did many years ago." It's very like mean girl shit.
Yeah, and Epic did that. They allowed alternative payment methods.
Yeah.
To skirt Apple's payment methods. They did that. As a clear sign of rebellion, and they knew they were going to get taken.
They did that so they could have reason for a lawsuit. They had the lawsuit ready to go, and then the second Apple pulled it, they're like, all right, we're suing you. Here's everything.
Yeah, and they even had a little commercial ready to go that was about why Fortnite's not on the iOS store and stuff. And that published immediately when they got deleted. So they knew exactly what they were doing. It was an act of protest.
Yeah.
So now Apple is using that act of protest against them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what else do we need?
It goes on from here. There's more sites about, like, you know, Epic has, in the past, Epic has... you know, gone against Apple's wishes. And a letter on February 26th, Tim Sweeney and a recent submission in the Australian litigation said Apple is concerned for Epic Games Sweden, does not intend to adhere to contractual commitments. Basically, it's a lot of like, Apple doesn't trust Epic, and Epic's just like, what do you mean? Why don't you trust us?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I mean, it's petty bullshit. Like, there's no reason for Apple to not allow Epic to continue to operate.
Right.
They know why they broke the rules back in the day.
It's
because of this whole thing. Like, Apple knows they're in the wrong because they lost they lost this case in the EU.
Yeah.
So the EU is like, no, Apple, you are wrong. And now they're being like, oh, but fucking Epic Games.
And it is all for naught because Epic got unbanned by Apple. A few days later, Epic Games will open its iOS app store in the European Union. After all, the game publisher had its developer license revoked. But Epic Games now says that Apple has reversed its decision. This is following an inquiry from the European Commission.
Why don't we just read the tweet from Tim Sweeney?
Okay. Like that. That'll make my life so much easier.
Wait, I liked this tweet. Did I even read this?
Because we're best friends. The DMA went through its first major challenge with Apple banning Epic Games Sweden from competing with the App Store, and the DMA just had its first major victory. Following a swift inquiry by the European Commission, Apple notified the Commission that Epic that it would relent and restore our access to bring back Fortnite and launch the Epic Games Store in Europe under the DMA law. A big win for European rule of law, for the European Commission, and for the freedom of developers worldwide to speak up. Free Fortnite.
Yeah, that's great. They must have known, like they're gonna get shit on for that. Like they're gonna break rules in the European Union if they try to skirt around it like that. Like, imagine them just removing developer licenses for people who want to make their own app store.
Yeah.
Like Steam wants to make something now that they're allowed to by European law, and then they're just like, no, you don't get to, take your license. Right? That'd be messed up.
Mm-hmm.
So anti-competitive or whatever the hell you want to call it. So this is great. This is good.
This is
government intervention gone right. We need more of this here in America. I would like to have alternative app stores
alternative pay methods.
Yeah.
You know, it sucks every time I open up the Kindle app and I want to buy a book. I can't. I have to go to the web browser or I have to go on my computer and do it. I can't just do it in app.
Yeah.
I can't subscribe to Spotify in app. I can't subscribe to Netflix in app.
Very dumb.
Yeah.
There's a lot of technology brought a lot of issues into the rule of law, and nobody in government understands these issues.
No.
It looks like they're understanding it in Europe, but that's because I think Europe doesn't have geriatrics in there.
Yeah.
In their,
well, they do, but I think they also have like they're more well aware like of the bigger issues.
And they're probably not being paid off by the big corporate. Yeah. That's another one of our issues, is that the big corporations are...
Yeah,
they're like the politicians are benefiting for the big corporations. Anyway, that's congrats to our EU listeners.
Yeah.
Another win for you guys.